Hi, I'm Reverend Dr. E.C. Carroll, one of the associate ministers here at the Fountain of Raleigh Fellowship, under the leadership of our pastor, the Reverend Paul L. Anderson. Today I want to share with you a meditation out of the Gospel of Matthew, the 14th chapter, verse 25 through 32. Now, in the fourth watch of the night, Jesus went to them walking on the sea. And when his disciples saw him walking on the sea, they were troubled, saying, "It is a ghost." And they cried out for fear. But immediately Jesus spoke to them, saying, "Be of good cheer. It is I. Do not be afraid." And Peter answered him and said, "Lord, if it is you, command me to come to you on the water." So he said, "Come." And when Peter had come down out of the boat, he walked on the water to go to Jesus. But when he saw the wind was boisterous, he was afraid, and beginning to sink, he cried out, saying, "Lord, save me." And immediately Jesus stretched out his hand and caught him and said to him, "O you of little faith, why did you doubt?" And when they got into the boat, the wind ceased. What I want to say to you today is, for this meditation, there's a very interesting thing that happens both in the Old Testament and the New Testament. The writers of certain books, both in the Old Testament and New Testament, they have this thing called, what I've called, open-ended inspirational gaps. And there is an open-ended inspirational gap in this story here of Peter walking on the water with Jesus. Isn't it interesting how Matthew has this very descriptive type of talk about this event that happens to Peter? He starts out saying it's the fourth watch of the night, saying that it was about 3 or 4 o'clock in the morning. It's dark out there. And then they say, "Well, it looks like it's a ghost." And then he keeps on going and starts talking about that he tells, that Peter says, "If it's you, Lord, bid me to come down." And then the Lord says one word, "Come." Peter gets down out of the boat. The writer of the text just keeps on describing this particular thing happening. But when he gets to verse 32, the writer just gets quiet. For all he says is, "And they get to the boat and they get back in." Well, here's the thing. Doesn't it make you kind of think, well, what was the conversation between Peter and Jesus as they walked back to the boat after Jesus reached out his hand and grabbed Peter? Don't you think that Peter might have looked at him and said, if it was in the modern day time texting someone on the boat, he would have said, "OMG, oh my God." And my brothers and sisters, it's interesting. Maybe that moment of open-ended inspirational gap where it make you go, But now, here it is, Peter, getting back into the boat. And I'm quite sure that Peter, probably later on when we find him, when Jesus asked the question, "Who do men say that I am?" I am quite sure that Peter had to think about that walking on the water situation, and he could not hardly wait to say, "Lord, you are the Christ, the Son of the living God." And so, my brothers and sisters, for this meditation, I want you to start thinking about, if you would, when was the last time you had a God moment where you really realized that God exists? And I'm quite sure that Peter, after Jesus reached out and grabbed him by the hand and they started walking back to the boat, he had to come to the realization that this Jesus has to be the Son of God. Think about it. And hopefully next time that we see each other, we'll have a great talk. So God bless and have a wonderful day.
thank you so very much for your prayerful support and all the things that we have done in ministry to help so many others. We encourage you to please remember to sow a seed. We sow seeds in more ways than one. We can tangibly sow a seed into this ministry by going to thefountainofraleigh.org and click at the donate button. It is from there you can safely and securely give through PayPal, or else you may use the Tithely app. We thank you so very much for your generous support in times past, and we thank you for your present support and what you will do in the future. May God richly bless you, exceedingly and abundantly above all that you're able to ask, say, or think, according to His power at work in you. God bless you.